Good morning, students. Welcome to Academia Ambala. Today, our topic is comparing unit fractions. To explain this concept, I have planned an activity for you. From this activity, you will understand the basic concept very well. So, let's start the activity. For this activity, I have taken four rectangular shaped strips of same size. Now I will take first strip and divide it in two equal parts like this, and I have colored one part out of two parts. Now I will take second strip and will divide it in three equal parts like this, and here I have colored one part out of three parts. Now I will take third strip, which I will divide in four equal parts like this, and here I have colored one part out of four equal parts. Now I will take fourth and last one and will divide it in eight equal parts like this, and here I have colored one part out of eight parts. So children, in each strip I have colored one part. Have you noticed something? 1/2, 1/3, 1/4 and 1/8. All these are unit fractions, because in these fractions 1 is as a numerator. So these kind of fractions are called unit fractions. Children, now we will compare unit fractions 1/1. First we will take part 1/2 and part 1/3. If we see what we have noticed, yes, 1/2 is bigger than 1/3. So children, 1/2 fraction is greater than fraction 1/3. Now let's take next example. When we compare part 1/8 and part 1/4, what we have noticed? Yes, 1/4 is bigger than 1/8, means 1/4 fraction is greater than 1/8. Now we will discuss next example. When we compare part 1/8 and part 1/3, yes, what you have noticed, children? Yes, very good. 1/3 is greater than 1/8. So children, 1/3 fraction is greater than 1/8. Children, from all these examples, what you have noticed? When we compare 1/2 and 1/3, in this fraction, denominator is lesser than the denominator of this fraction, but this fraction is greater than this fraction. Let's check in next example. 1/4 is greater than 1/8, but if we look at the denominator part, that is lesser than the denominator of other fraction. Let's see in third example also. 1/3 is greater than 1/8, but if we look at the denominator part, this is lesser than this denominator. So children, what we have learned from this activity? we have learned that the fraction with lesser denominator is greater than the fraction with bigger denominator. Children, this is direct method from which you can find out which unit fraction is greater and which unit fraction is smaller. Now we will discuss another method of comparing unit fractions, which is cross multiplication method. So let's start. First, I have taken example 1 by 7 and 1 by 5. I'll compare these examples, these fractions, by cross multiplication method. First, I will multiply numerator of first fraction by the denominator of second fraction. And then I will multiply numerator of second fraction by the denominator of first fraction. 1 into 7. 1 into 5 is 5 and 1 into 7 is 7. So can you see which is bigger number? Yes, 7 is bigger than 5. As 7 belongs to this fraction and 5 belongs to this fraction, so 1 by 5 is greater than 1 by 7. So this is cross multiplication method by which we can compare unit fractions. Now let's take another example, 1 by 11 and 1 by 7. First, I will multiply numerator of first fraction by the denominator of second fraction, 1 into 7. Then I will multiply numerator of second fraction and denominator of first fraction, 1 multiplied by 11. 1 multiplied by 7, 7, and 1 multiplied by 11, 11. So you can see 11 is greater than 7. So if we check, 11 belongs to this fraction and 7 belongs to this fraction. So this fraction means 1 by 7 is greater than 1 by 11. So children, this is cross multiplication method. Today we have discussed two methods of comparing unit fractions. Do exercise 5.2. In that exercise, you will find these kind of questions. So children, thank you and have a nice day.